Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're doing a video on the best performance modifications for the Duramax L5P. The Duramax L5P produces 445 horsepower and 910 feet-pounds of torque. On a dyno, a stock L5P will produce about 400 wheel horsepower and 850 wheel torque. While those are pretty good numbers, it's always fun to add a little bit more power to whatever vehicle it is, and the L5P is no different. Basic bolt-on mods on the L5P can take it around the 550 to 600 wheel horsepower mark and can produce over 1200 wheel torque. Pushing past the 600 wheel horsepower mark is when things start to get really expensive and you need to start looking into more advanced modifications. So this guide is mostly going to focus on the bolt-on modifications that can get you right up to those power limits where you'll then need to start thinking about putting a lot more money into it to get to the next echelon. Before jumping into the modifications themselves, there's a couple important things to talk about with respect to the power limits of the Duramax L5P as well as its transmission. The biggest weakness to modifying any Duramax is the Allison 1000 transmission. While they're great transmissions, they're extremely reliable, they're not known to be able to handle a whole lot of additional power. The Allison 1000 on the L5P can handle about 550 wheel horsepower before you're gonna need a fully built transmission. However, once you get to around the 500 wheel horsepower mark is when you're going to suffer with respect to reliability out of the transmission. Once you get to around those levels, you're going to either want to look into transmission tuning or getting an EPC solenoid fooler to be able to increase line pressure. Next is the stock turbo. The stock turbo maxes out at about 550 to 600 wheel horsepower. With that being said, even at 550 wheel horsepower, that thing is really chugging along. And so you're gonna sacrifice a lot of reliability out of your turbo if you're running it at 550. But it can be pushed up to about 600 before it's completely capped out. The nice thing about the L5P is that from a fueling standpoint, the fuel pump can actually handle over 800 wheel horsepower, and it does have a factory lift pump, which is good at those power levels as well. From a fueling standpoint, to be able to push up to those numbers, the only thing that you need is upgraded injectors, but you can typically hold off on upgrading those injectors until you're looking at turbocharger upgrades. So those injectors should be good up into the mid to upper 500s. So we can get to about 550 wheel horsepower off of some basic bolt-on mods. However, at 550 wheel horsepower, we're not really building a very reliable engine. So even to just push 550 wheel horsepower reliably, you're probably looking somewhere between $12,000 to $15,000 in upgrades between tuning, a built transmission, turbocharger upgrades, injector upgrades, and a few other things along the way. Realistically, I would say about 500 wheel horsepower is the safe number to run without running into the need to put a lot of additional money into upgraded parts like the turbocharger and the transmission as well. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump into our best modifications here. The first one is ECM tuning. Now, the L5P is a bit more difficult to tune because the ECM is completely locked from the factory, and so the only way to actually custom tune it is to pull the ECM off and to send it off to someone like HP Tuners, which is gonna run you somewhere around $2,500 to get all the tuning done that you need. Fortunately, there are a couple piggyback tuners like the Edge Pulsar and the Banks Derringer. Both of those will add somewhere around 100 horsepower and 150 torque. You're not getting quite as much as you would out of custom tuning from HP Tuners, since they can build tunes that provide 200 to 250 horsepower, but you are getting a little bit more affordable of a product as well as something that's simply plug and play rather than having to pull your ECM and ship it off and wait to get it back. Second thing is a cold air intake. Once you throw a tune on the car, you increase boost pressure that the turbo's running. It's helpful to bring more air into the engine through a cold air intake. In addition to that, you'll get better throttle response. You'll get faster turbo spool. It makes some cool engine noises, and you'll also get some small gas mileage improvements out of it. You get good power gains, nothing too crazy, probably about 10 wheel horsepower when you're tuned, but bringing that extra air into the engine just helps with the turbo and the turbo efficiency, and so it helps take a little bit of stress off of that. The third modification on our list is a 5-inch exhaust system. Probably the best exhaust modification is just deleting all of the emission stuff out of it. But outside of going through the hassle of doing that, the next best option is getting a catback or emissions back 5-inch exhaust system. Once we throw a tuner on it, increase boost, and are bringing more air into the engine with an intake, we're gonna want a way to let that air get out of the engine through the exhaust system. With an exhaust system, you're probably only getting 5, maybe 10 wheel horsepower gains, but you're reducing back pressure and you're lowering EGTs, and lowering EGTs results in a cooler and a healthier engine, and the reduction of back pressure also takes a lot of stress off of the turbocharger as well. The fourth on our list is an intake horn. The stock intake horn is relatively small and restrictive. It's only about 2.4 inches in diameter. A popular upgrade is buying an aftermarket intake horn. Most of them come in 3.5 inch configurations, and what this does is significantly increase the amount of airflow that's going through the intake and into the intake manifold. This mod also improves air inflow in addition to an intake. You'll see some modest gains from it as well, but the biggest benefit again is efficiently bringing more air into the engine to be able to help the turbocharger and the turbocharger's efficiency. The last mod on our list is a downpipe, and a downpipe is honestly our favorite exhaust modification over a 5-inch exhaust system, and that's because the downpipe sits the closest to the turbo. And so upgrading the downpipe to a less restrictive downpipe will have the greatest impact on back pressure reduction. And what that does is increases turbo spool, so it helps with turbo reliability, but it's also gonna have the biggest impact on exhaust gas temperatures and reducing those. The reason that we put this on the bottom of the list after a 5-inch exhaust system is purely just because a downpipe is a little bit more difficult to actually install on the vehicle. Installing it on the L5P, I think, is probably a 4 to 6 hour job to get to it, remove the factory one and put an upgraded one on it. Whereas adding an exhaust system from the emissions back part of the exhaust is a pretty simple DIY. Here we have our boosted performance Duramax L5P upgraded downpipe. This fits all 2017 to 2023 L5P models. And as we've discussed, it is hands down the best exhaust modification for the L5P. This downpipe is made from 304 stainless steel. And so this is one of the highest quality materials you can get out there. This is not going to rust like some of the other cheaper L5P downpipes on the market. Additionally, it has a nice little heat shield on it just to help reduce heat coming off of the downpipe. We believe that this is the best combination of price, quality, and performance on the market. So head on over to boostedperformance.com to pick yours up today. So that covers it for our five best modifications. We believe in overbuilding and underpowering. A tune itself can get you to the 500 wheel horsepower mark, but it's not the most reliable way of doing it. Increasing airflow helps reduce stress on the turbocharger, and increasing exhaust flow also helps result in lower EGTs, which means a cooler and a healthier engine, but it also reduces a lot of pressure and stress on the turbocharger as well. While you can get there just off of a tune, just doing a tune is not the most reliable way of getting to that 500 wheel horsepower mark. And you're also gonna have to be running a pretty aggressive tune to get it all the way up there. Whereas when you have these additional supporting modifications, you can get there a bit more easily because you don't need to be as aggressive with your tuning. If you want a really simple setup just to add a little bit of additional power to the truck, I would say drop a plug and play Banks Derringer or Edge Pulsar on it, throw an intake on it and call it good. If you want to push the engine a little bit more or provide additional reliability and a little bit more of a free flowing engine, then I'd recommend getting the exhaust systems done, the catback as well as the downpipe, and adding an intake horn to the intake system as well. Even with these mods only, you're gonna wanna at least look into the EPC solenoid fooler or into transmission tuning, because all of these mods here here will put you pretty easily into that 500 wheel horsepower range, which is when the Allison 1000 starts to lose a bit of its reliability. Again, getting to this 500 wheel horsepower mark is pretty easy to do. You can still have a very reliable L5P at these power levels. However, when you want to push past them, it's when you really want to start looking at upgrades. We're not a fan of running 550 wheel horsepower on a turbocharger that can only handle 550 to maybe 600. Really, after these bolt-ons is when you're going to start having to consider whether you want to go down the path of putting probably a five-figure number of modifications into this car to really get to those next echelon of power levels. We hope this information was helpful for you. Feel free to drop any comments below and we'll do our best to help you determine which mods are best for your L5P depending on what your power goals are and what you're looking to do with it. If you appreciated this video, go ahead and click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more Duramax content.